the first concert of the summer of 2024, our Swansea Village Concert Series. I want to welcome Matt York, who is going to dazzle us with his music. Matt is our, it's the first time he's here, and it's his first appearance in Swansea. And he's going to sing music we love, music of the Highwaymen, Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson, Chris Christopherson, Waylon Jennings. I want to take 2 seconds to thank the Swansea Cultural Council, who gives us our money to have these wonderful concerts, the Friends of the Swansea Public Library, Christ Church, who provides us with this beautiful tent and this beautiful yard to do all this, and all of the volunteers that help out. And I'm so grateful that you've all come tonight. So, without further ado, because I could stand here and tell you all about all the summer things we have planned at the library, and everybody knows that the library is now at the First Christian Congregational Church, right? Does everybody know that? Because people are still showing up at this library and they can't get in. So don't go here. Come visit us right on the corner of Route 6 and Maple Avenue. Without further ado, Matt York.
Thank you. Thank you. Hi. Hi. Thank you very much. I don't believe that I have ever set foot in Swansea, so it's great to be here. This seems like a very good way to start off things here. My name is Matt York. I live in Pembroke. I live on the South Shore, and all I do is drive. I've been a professional musician a good chunk of my life doing my own music, and I started doing the songs of the Highwaymen, and if you're not a big country music fan, the Highwaymen were Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson, Waylon Jennings, and the great Johnny Cash. I used to be a newspaper writer when I was younger, and I wrote a book about the Highwaymen, and I just kind of go around, and all I do is drive, and I sing songs, and I make poor food decisions, and I make dumb jokes. You can find that out, too. And this is a song called My Heroes Have Always Been Cowboys. I grew up dreaming of being a cowboy, loving the cowboy, pursuing the life of my high-riding heroes. I burned up my childhood days. I learned all the rules of a modern-day drifter. Don't you hold on to nothing too long. Just take what you need from the ladies, then leave them with the words of a sad country song. My heroes have always been cowboys. Oh, they still are, it seems. Sadly in search of but one step in back of themselves and their slow-moving dreams. Cowboys are special, their own brand of misery, being alone too long. You die from the cold in the arms of a nightmare, knowing well your best days are gone. Picking up hookers instead of my pen, I let the words of my youth fade away. Old worn out, and old worn out memories, and no one, no place to go. My heroes, they've always been cowboys. Ah, oh, they still are, it seems. Sadly in search of the one step in back of themselves and their slow-moving dreams. Sadly in search of the one step in back of themselves and their slow-moving dreams. Same guitar for 30 years. I have two of them that I've had almost that long, but the one that I usually play I've had for 30 years, and it's just getting sick and tired of sitting in a 90 degree car every day, which is all it really does as I drive around. And so I was at the guitar shop this morning and I asked him, I said, hey, can you just make this better? And he said, I can, but I need to take it for a week. And so he gave me this guitar to hold me over for a few days. And I have never played this guitar, but it seems nice. And yeah, thanks. Good. If it sounds terrible at any point, it's probably the guitar's fault. I'm gonna. On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. That my love is making music with my friends. Oh well, I can't wait to get on the road again. Places I ain't never been, seeing things that I may never see again. Oh well, I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again, like a band of gypsies, will we go down the highway? Oh, with the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning out. Always, it's on the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. Love, my love is making music with my friends. Oh well, I can't wait to get on the road again.
keep turning our way. Our way is on the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. Oh, well, I can't wait to get on the road again. I can't wait to get on the road again.
I can't find the little thing that I'm looking for, so I'm just going to talk to you guys while I look for it, and I'll kind of act like I'm finding it. All right, so I started out doing these Highwaymen concerts a couple years ago, and I don't know, people seemed to tolerate them, and then they said, you should do something different and come back. And so then last year I went, and I just went to a gazillion towns and did the songs of Johnny Cash. And they were like, that wasn't bad either, you should come back again. And now this year I'm doing the songs of Willie Nelson. And so... So some days I am fake Willie, and then I go straight to another gig where I'm fake Johnny Cash. I have not been the Highwayman for a few weeks. So the four Highwaymen were Willie Nelson, Waylon Jennings, Kris Kristofferson, and Johnny Cash. Between the four Highwaymen, there were a total of 13 wives and 27 children. So Waylon Jennings was married 4 times with 6 kids. Cash was married twice with 5 children. Kristofferson had 8 children from 3 marriages, and Willie Nelson has been married 4 times and has 8 children. Willie Nelson is 91 years old. He's supposed to be at Great Woods. God love Willie. God love Willie. He's supposed to be there on Tuesday night, but he just canceled some shows because of illness. So, see how that goes. This next song is a song called Big River, and it's a song that was on the first Highwaymen album. They did 3 albums together, 1985, 1990, and 1995. They'd all been big stars for a lot of years. This is a song that Cash released in the 1950s, but that they also did on the first Highwaymen album. Weekend willow, how to cry, cry, cry. And I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. Here's I cried for that woman, well, they're gonna flood you, big river. Oh, I'm gonna sit right here until I die. Well, I met her accidentally in St. Paul, and so off tore me up every time I heard her draw, southern draw. Back downstream, Fort and Davenport, and I followed you, Big River, all when you called. Oh, you took me to St. Louis, later on down the river. Said she's been there, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. I found her trail in Memphis. Oh, she just dropped up the bluff. She raised a few eyebrows and she went on down alone. Now won't you batter down my Baton Rouge, River Queen, or will it all? Take that woman on down to New Orleans, New Orleans. Willow, how to cry, cry, cry. And I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. Here's I cried for that woman, well, they're gonna flood you, Big River. Oh, I'm gonna sit right here until I die. Well, I'm gonna sit right here until I die. Someone mentioned that they saw me here a couple years ago, or I don't know, sometime in the past, in Somerset, and yeah, give it up for Somerset. And Somerset was one of my favorite moments of doing this thing, is that a lady came up to me afterwards at one of, I don't know, I think it was the first, I think I was there 2 years ago the first time, and a lady came up to me and she, I played this next song, which is going to be Patsy Cline's Crazy, which was written by Willie Nelson. And she came up to me and she said, here is $20 for your book, here is $10 for your CD. I did not like your version of Patsy Cline's Crazy. And I was going to be like, well, look, we're at a library. This is free. I mean, you know, I can't reinvent Patsy Cline, but that's okay. You know, that's fine. And so I tell that story sometimes because I totally kept her money. It was fine. You know, I was like, I was totally. But I love that she said it. And so I was telling that story somewhere else about 6 months later, and a lady came up to me afterwards. And she said, you know, I got to agree with that moment. So what I'm saying, folks, is get ready to be disappointed. Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. Crazy. Crazy for feeling so blue. I knew me as long as you want, and then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? Wondering, what in the world did I do? Thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for crying, crazy for trying. I'm crazy for loving you. Crazy for crying, try. I'm crazy for loving. There you go. I mean, it's not like offensively bad. As a kid growing up, I just knew Kris Kristofferson as the guy that my mom thought was really good looking, and that was a movie star. I didn't know much about his music or about him. And, you know, many of you sure probably do, but he was a Rhodes Scholar. He was one of the great scholastic athletes of all time. He was a pilot in the military. He was a Golden Gloves boxer. He had all of these different things that he did. And when he was leaving the military, he decided to move to Nashville, and he took a job as a recording at a recording studio, working as a custodian, just so that he could kind of be around that world and get his songs hopefully into the hands of people that were there. And it worked. Johnny Cash immediately recognized Kristofferson's talent. And Willie and Bob Dylan have both talked about how, you know, there was Nashville prior to Kristofferson's arrival, and then there was Nashville afterwards, and just the depth of the lyrics that he wrote. And I'm going to play the song Sunday Morning Coming Down right now. And by the time you get to the end of this song, you feel like you've read, you know, a script to just an incredible movie. And, you know, he really, I think, changed the way people started writing from that point on. And I know Willie has talked about how, you know, he really felt like it forced him to kind of write even better songs. And Willie's pretty good. That Willie's pretty good at writing songs. This is Sunday Morning Coming Down. Wait, I'm going to tell you one more Sunday. Hold on. I was down in the beautiful town of Chatham. I don't know, like 2 months ago. Sometimes I go to churches and I sing the gospel songs of these guys. And so that's what I was doing. And a lady came up to me afterwards, and she was probably about 75 years old. She came up to me and she said, I want to buy your CD of you singing the songs of the Highwaymen, and I want to send it to my friend Chris Christopherson. And I said, well, how do you know Chris Christopherson? And she said, well, I almost married him in 1981, but my friend ended up marrying him instead because I didn't want to have any more kids, and he wanted to have more kids. And they had 5 more kids, and they're still married, and the 3 of us have stayed friends for all these years, and all the time that he would come down and perform down the Cape, he would always stay at our house and stuff. And I had like a million questions for her, and I have not heard from Chris Christopherson. But I was leaving the church, and there was this little lady, she was like one of the like little four foot tall, little tiny people, and she was awesome. And she's like, you know that lady you were just talking to? And I said, yeah. And she said, that lady and Christopherson, they used to have a thing. Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head that didn't hurt. All the beer I had for breakfast, it wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled in my closet, through my clothes, found my cleanest dirty shirt. Washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I'd spoke my mind the night before, with cigarettes and songs that I've been picking. But I lit my first and I watched a small kid, I played with a can that he was kicking. Across the street, I caught the Sunday smell of someone fried chicken. Oh, it took me back to something that I lost somewhere, somehow, along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Your body feel alone. Yeah, there's nothing short of dying. Oh, half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk. Sunday morning coming now. In the park I saw a daddy with the laughing little girl that he was swinging. And I stopped beside a Sunday school. I listened to the songs that they were singing. Then I headed down the street, somewhere far away, a lonely bell was ringing. It echoed through the canyons like disappearing dreams of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Oh, there's something in a Sunday that'll make your body feel alone. Sunday morning coming down. Yeah. Whoa. Thank you. And I tell you, maybe you'll find it funny, maybe you won't. I'm going to tell you a story either way. And I fell in love with Southern gospel music and about a year ago. And I'm not a particularly religious person. I wasn't a church-going kid. But I hugely believe in the spirituality of music and things like that. And just gospel music just became all-consuming for me. And I said, I'm going to find a place where I can go listen to gospel music. So I started going to this church on Dorchester Ave in Southie called the Fourth Church. It's a Presbyterian church. And they just have this incredible music. And I just went there and I just immediately fell in love with it. And it's run by this professor at Harvard Divinity School. And there's four, I guess, different folks from the Harvard that are involved in that church. And so I've become fast friends with those guys, and we've been doing a lot of really great gospel music. And so on Sunday, they asked me to come there and play three songs where I'm just going to be doing exactly what I'm doing, and then there's going to be like 25 of them behind me singing, and which should be pretty cool. But I have two teenage daughters that are very, very good at reminding me how dumb I am at all things. And they... So I just was on a group text. I just received a group text right before I was setting up here, and it was me and three Harvard professors, and I texted it to my girls, and I was like, maybe I should just call this group chat my Harvard friends. And they're like, oh, God. I didn't go to Harvard.
Well, they tell me of a home far beyond the sky. Oh, they tell me of a home that's far away. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an uncloudy day. Oh, the land of cloudless days. Tell me of a home where my friends have gone. Oh, they tell me of that land that's far away, where the tree of life's an eternal sheds its fragrance from the unclouded.
I found when I go around and I do the songs of the Highwaymen that that people are a lot less familiar with Waylon Jennings than they are the other three members of the Highwaymen. Waylon's one of my very, very favorites. He was a huge star. He had 15 number one hits on the charts through the years on the country charts. And he had this really interesting story himself in that he grew up as a DJ as a teenager in Texas. He became a DJ at a rock and roll station down there, and he became friends with Buddy Holly. And then he became Buddy Holly's bass player. And had he not swapped seats with the Big Bopper, he would have been on the plane the day that the music died. But instead, he was on a bus, and he found out the next morning when they arrived at the next city that they were supposed to play. And he really carried that kind of grief with him. He had a lot of, he really battled drugs and alcohol issues for a big part of his life. But to me, he was one of the very, very greatest of all time. And he was this classic country star. He was a good-looking guy. He was a rebel through and through. He could sing like nobody else. And in the early 70s, he just decided he wanted to do things his own way. And he was a big enough star that he could. And so, you know, a lot of the Nashville albums that were coming out at that time, they sounded very similar because, you know, they had a lot of the same session musicians playing on all those records, a lot of the same harmony arrangements. A lot of string arrangements were the same. And so there wasn't a huge difference a lot of the times between what a Tammy Wynette's album sounded like and a George Jones album or whoever, Merle Haggard album. And so Waylon was a big enough star, and when those guys would go out on the road, they'd be playing it with a five-piece band. They didn't have strings. They didn't have, you know, big harmonies. And his band was just incredible. And he said, listen, I'm not going to re-sign my deal unless you allow me to have creative control. And they gave it to him, and he released an album called Honky Tonk Heroes in 1972 or sort of around there, and that a lot of people think of as the greatest country album of all time. I think it's the greatest country album of all time. And at the same time, Willie Nelson's manager was also Waylon's manager, and Willie also gained creative control at that same point. And that's when you started hearing the really great, great Willie albums like Phases and Stages or Redheaded Stranger and Stardust. They all came out shortly thereafter. This is a song from Honky Tonk Heroes that was written by the great Billy Joe Shaver. It's called Black Rose. Way down in Virginia, amongst the tall-grown sugar cane, lives a simple man and a bottle of gin and a rose of a different name. Well, the first time I felt lightning, I was standing in the drizzling rain with a trembling hand and a bottle of gin and the rose of a different name. The devil made me do it the first time. Second time I done it on my own. The Lord put a handle on a simple-headed man, helped me lead that black rose along. Oh, when the devil made that woman, oh, he threw the pattern away, 'cause they were built for speed with the tools you need to make a new fool every day. Way down deep and dirty, on the other side of shame, you'll find this chain-cutting man doing it again with that rose of a different name. Simple-headed man, help me leave that black rose alone. Devil made me do it the first time. Second time I done it on my own. Oh, the Lord put a handle on a simple-headed man, help me leave that black rose alone. Thank you. That's such a great song. Thank you very much. The song, the only song I knew by Waylon Jennings when I was a kid, I knew the Dukes of Hazzard theme song. That was Waylon Jennings. And he was the narrator of that show. And I was like 10 years old. And I knew that I loved that song, I loved that orange car, and I loved Daisy Duke. And but I don't know anything else about it. This is Waylon and Willie. Cowboys ain't easy to love, and they're harder to hold. They'd rather give you a song than diamonds of gold. Belt buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. And if you don't understand him, and he don't die, he'll probably just ride away. Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive a old truck. Make them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Oh, they'll never stay home. Well, they're always alone, even with someone they love. Cowboys like smoky old pool rooms and clear mountain mornings. Little warm puppies, children and girls of the night. Them that don't know him won't like him, and them that do sometimes won't know how to take it. Oh, he ain't wrong, it's just different. But his pride won't let him do the things to make you think he's right. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive boats. Make them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies stay home, till always alone, even with someone they love. Thanks so much. That was Waylon and Waylon and Waylon. I was playing a song, doing the songs of Willie Nelson last week in the beautiful town of Belmont, and a lady started crying during one of the songs that I was playing, and her husband was giving her a hard time about it in between when I was doing this little thing that I do when I talk, and she yelled out from the audience. She said, "Could you play a Johnny Cash song? Because that'll make him cry." This is the go-to one when I try to. It's one of the songs. Like, Johnny Cash actually just put out a new album today. He passed away 21 years ago, but he recorded this group of songs that they'd never released that just literally came out today. I was listening to it on the drive down. It's really sounding, it's really pretty sounding stuff. This is a song from later in his life. I've been ungrateful. I've been unwise, restless from the cradle. Now I realize it's so hard to see the rainbow through glasses dark as these.
on my knees.
Summer song for you, huh?
I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna cross that river. I'm gonna catch tomorrow now. Like I always told you, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone. Nobody here will ever find me, but I'll always be around. Just like the songs I leave behind me, I'm gonna live forever now. Be good to one another. Be sure to raise your children right. Don't let the darkness take them. Don't let them feel forsaken. Just lead them safely to the light. When this old world is blown asunder and all the stars fall from the sky, stay together, you and I. I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna cross that river. I'm gonna catch tomorrow now. I'm gonna live forever. I'm gonna cross that river. I'm gonna catch tomorrow.
Thank you very much. That song was also written by Billy Joe Shaver. That song was done by Johnny Cash. The Highwaymen did it on one of their albums. And then Willie did it a couple of years ago and actually won the Grammy for it, I think in 2021, I want to say. It's such a beautiful song. If you thought I sounded like Patsy Cline a lot earlier, I'm sure you did. Wait till you hear me do Janis Joplin, folks. Chris Christopherson wrote this song. And Roger Miller actually released this song originally and had a hit with it on the country charts. Christopherson and Janice dated briefly right before she passed away, and the story goes that that he had never heard it, her version of it was released after she died, but that the day after she passed away, he went into the studio and listened to it for the first time, and obviously it would go on to be one of the great songs of all time. Busted flat in Baton Rouge, heading for the train, feeling nearly faded as my jeans. Bobby thumbed the diesel down just before it rained. Took us all the way to New Orleans. I took my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana, and I was blowing sad while Bobby sang the blues. Them windshield wipers slapping time, and Bobby clapping hands, we finally sang up every song that driver knew. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing ain't worth nothing all but free. Feeling good was easy, Lord, when Bobby sang the blues. A buddy that was good enough for me. Good enough for me and Bobby. From the coal mines of Kentucky out of the California sun, Bobby shared the secrets of my soul. Standing right beside me, Lord, through everything I've done. Oh, every night she kept me from the cold. Oh, somewhere near Salinas, Lord, I let her slip away. Oh, that home, and I hope she'll find me. And I trade all my tomorrows for a single yesterday. Holding Bobby's body next to mine. Just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing left is all she left for me. Feeling good was easy, Lord, when Bobby sang the blues. A buddy that was good enough for me. Good enough for me and Bobby McGee. Thank you very much. I'd say this guitar is fair. It's Martin guitar. I have two Martins, and they're both, like I said, a million years old, and they've been thrown around the back of trucks and planes and all kinds of stuff, but they're kind of like buying a, you know, Mercedes or a BMW. They're a very high end, beautiful instrument, and this feels like I drive a Honda Accord, so I'm not knocking Honda in any way. I stopped on the Honda dealership on my ride here because I've got 165,000 on the Accord, but this plays more like a nice Honda Civic. It's not, you know what I mean? So like it has like the camera if you're backing up and has all that, but it's, yeah. This isn't gonna be the one. This is not the one. I hear the train a coming. It's rolling round the bend. And I ain't seen the sunshine since. Well, I don't know when. Well, I'm stuck in Folsom Prison. All time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps on rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. Well, I shot a man in Reno, oh, just to watch him die. Oh, when I hear that whistle blow, I hang my head and I.
met this rich folks eating from a fancy dining car. While they're drinking coffee, we'll smoke and big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free.
Song. Let's see if I can do this little thing. I got this. I'm not texting or anything. I'm doing work here. Hold on. So Johnny Cash was stationed in Germany when he was in the military when he wrote that song. He wasn't a musician really. He was just figuring out how to write music and write songs. And he saw the movie Behind the Walls of Folsom Prison, and he thought that'd be a good thing to write a song about. And he was right? That worked out really well. This song came out about 10 years before that song.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling round the bend, and I ain't been kissed, Lord, since I don't know when. The boys in Crescent City.
So, I mean, there's similarities there, right? And so when he put out that song in the 50s, they did not, they didn't try to sue him or anything. And then it's one of those rare songs where he did that song on Folsom Prison, at Folsom Prison album, a live version that was a much more upbeat, much more electrified version, and got maybe a bigger hit out of it the second time around. And when that happened, they did sue him for plagiarism, and he settled out of court with them for $75,000, which seems like a really, really good deal if you're Johnny Cash, you know. This is a beautiful song that Willie does and a bunch of people do. It's called The Wild Side of Life, one of my favorite songs. You wouldn't read the letter if I wrote you. You asked me not to call you on the phone. But there's something that I've been wanting to tell you. So I wrote it in the words of this song. I didn't know God made honky-tonk angels. I might have known you'd never make a wife. You gave up the only one who ever loved you. On went back to the wild side of life. Gay night life has lured you to the places where the wine and liquor flow, where you ain't to be anybody's darling. forget the truest love you'll ever know. I didn't know God made honky-tonk angels. Well, I might have known you'd never make a wife. You gave up the only one who ever loved you. On went back to the wild side of life. Oh, you went back to the wild side of life. Thank you. Thank you so much. So they said I could go 60 minutes to 90 minutes. And I said, what I would do is I would read the crowd. So when you probably think I'm just looking out there, but I'm working. And so what I'm gonna do, we're at the 56 minute mark, and I'm just gonna keep going a little longer. And I think what would be helpful, and I've never done this before, but here's my thought, is if you're just kind of had enough, just put your phone out. You know, just kind of go on your phone, start scrolling. You know, start talking, FaceTime somebody. You know, I play to an older audience a lot of times, so I get a lot of ringers. People that haven't decided to silence their phone, and so any of those things. And then if it really gets bad, just start getting up and talking or whatever, and I'll know. But my thought is maybe another 15 minutes. But again, we can change this. I was down in Nashville a little over a year ago, and I was playing at a really great room down there called City Winery, which is give it up for City Winery in Nashville. I had performed in Nashville a whole bunch of times through the years doing my own music, but I hadn't gone down there and done the songs of the Highwaymen, and as I mentioned earlier, I wrote a book about them, so this was a really big opportunity for me, and I was petrified that there would be nobody there when I went and performed. And turns out, huge fans down there of Nashville, they love the country music down there. And so it was one of the greatest nights of my life, actually. It was a wonderful, wonderful time. One of the things that I got to do to promote the concert was I got to go on the NBC morning show down there called Today in Nashville. And I had done that show before doing my own music, but if you don't have written permission from an artist, you can't do their songs on even what was really just regional, but network television. And so I couldn't do any of the songs I would have thought to do. And I wouldn't have even known how to begin the process of getting those rights because it was just thrown together very quickly. And so if a song is over 100 years old, it goes into the public domain and then anybody can do whatever they want with that song. And so Will the Circle Be Unbroken is a song that was written in 1908. And it's an old Christian hymn that was first made famous by Maybelle Carter and the Carter family in the 1930s. Maybelle was June Carter's mother. And to this day, Willie Nelson plays it almost every night at his concerts. And Cash always played it at his concerts as well. And that's kind of how I kind of just started down this path of playing these gospel songs, and I'm going down to New Orleans in September to record this album with just this big blend of all kinds of awesome folks and making this album. And I don't know what it's going to sound like, but I'm really excited about finding out. And this song is a song called Mansion Just Over the Hilltop. I'm satisfied with just a cottage below, a little silver, a little gold. But in that city where the ransomed will shine, I want a gold one, that silver line. I've got a mansion just over the hilltop, in that bright land where we'll never grow. Oh, someday I'm in. Paramore wander, but walk on the streets that of pure gold. Don't think me poor, deserted or lonely. I'm not discouraged, though I'm heaven bound. I'm just a pilgrim in search of a city. I want a mansion, a harp and a crown. I've got a man just over the hilltop in that bright land where I will never grow. Oh, someday yonder I will never grow fonder. I will walk on streets that are pure. Thank you very much. Thank you. How many phones? Nobody's got their phones out. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to be the first one that takes the phone out. My dad was that guy that, like, he had to be the first one to leave everything. And, like really before everything. And I remember my sister and I bought him tickets to go see, I think it was the Pretenders and the B-52s at Great Woods. And all of you know how, if you've been to Great Woods, you know how the parking has not improved there in any way. I grew up in Foxborough, and it was terrible the day it opened, and my daughter got home the other day at like 2:30, and maybe she was just out doing something, I don't know what she was doing, but she got home at 2:30 and she blamed it on the parking lot. And I don't know why I'm telling you that story, folks. Let's just move on. I'm gonna play a song by a guy by the name of Merle Haggard. And if you're a fan of the music that I've been playing tonight, you might be a fan of Merle Haggard. And if you're not, you should be, because Merle was really, really good. And Merle Haggard, if you're not familiar with him, basically from the ages of about 12 to 22, he was incarcerated in juvenile lockups and then later on in adult prisons for a variety of crimes. He wasn't a drug addict. He wasn't a violent guy particularly. He was the 14-year-old kid that would steal your car, crash it into a tree, get sent to a juvenile lockup, break out of that juvenile lockup, disappear, they'd find him, they'd put him in another one, he'd break out of that one. He ended up in San Quentin prison, and while he was there, Johnny Cash came and performed a concert. And he saw Cash, and Merle was already singing and playing guitar a little bit, but he was also in jail. And so he said, you know, I think when I get out of here, I'll just go become Johnny Cash. That seems like a terrific job. And so that's what he did. And Merle would go on to have 30 number one hits on the country charts. He had twice as many number ones as Johnny Cash, more than Willie, more than just about anybody. And you know, it's a funny thing in this day and age where you can come to the church here and see, you know, the fake Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson guy sing songs for you, and then you can grab a business card or whatever, and you can find out where I'll be and where I've been and what my deal is. But back then, you could get out of San Quentin prison, and like a year or two later, you could be on the Grand Ole Opry, and nobody knew where you'd just come from. And so Merle's star just kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and he knew this was going to be an issue at some point. And Johnny Cash had this really influential television show on ABC that some of you may remember called The Johnny Cash Show in the late 60s and early 70s. And so he called Cash and asked him, you know, he said, what do you think I should do? And Cash said, I think you should come on my show. and I should interview you, and you should just, you know, talk about it. And that's what he did, and he talked about, you know, he didn't talk, he told the story of his, he had an incredibly tough upbringing. His dad passed away when he was 9 years old. His home was literally a train car that had just been, like, left in Bakersfield, California. And so the songs that he was writing weren't songs about committing crimes. They weren't about felons. They were songs about the downtrodden, the luckless of the world. And I think it was a really big moment in country music that he did that. And they called Merle Haggard the poet of the working man. And he might be my favorite singer of all time. And this is a hard song to sing, but it's such a pretty song. It's called Sometimes I Dream. This is gonna be the last sad one, then we're gonna go up, okay? See, then Martin wouldn't have done that. Did they hear that? I have a Great Dane. It's 130 pounds, its name's Tiny. And I had a Weimaraner for 13 years, and her name was Belvedere. And she's the greatest dog to ever walk the earth. Nobody's loved me the way Belvedere loved me. And then we got Tiny shortly thereafter. And Tiny's nothing but nice and dopey and doesn't do anything wrong. But she was like this rebound dog for me, and I've never developed a relationship with Tiny the way I have. Meanwhile, I have a framed photo of Belvedere sitting right next to my bed. Belvedere died 8 years ago, so that didn't have anything to do with the Highwaymen, folks, but I did feel like it was important to share. Oh, there's no magic way for me to get over you. There's not much I could say. Oh, not a lot left to do. Seldom I laugh. Oh, seldom I ever cry. But there's times when I drink too much. Oh, there's times when I lie. Sometimes I hate myself and wish I could scream. Sometimes I give up on love. Oh, but sometimes I dream. Sometimes I dream. Looking out through my window, speeding through the night on a long limousine. There's a curse on my heart. Oh, I'll never love again. Forever a lonely man. Oh, but sometimes I dream. More songs for you. Thank you very much for coming and listening. It's nice to have a little, it's like windy a little bit. It's nice. Marty Stewart was Johnny Cash's son-in-law for a short period of time, but is also one of the great country musicians of all time. And Marty Stewart used to say that there was two kinds of people in this world. There are people who love Johnny Cash's music, and there are those that will. And that has absolutely been the, you know, I actually figured out how to like make a living doing that. And so, and it's remarkable to me. I always say, like I said, I play oftentimes to older audiences, but I also play a ton of bar gigs. And in fact, I was just at one a couple nights ago. And it's amazing to me that these 20-year-old kids, they know who Johnny Cash is. They know Ring of Fire. They know Folsom Prison. And they love those songs the same way their parents did, the same way their grandparents did. And it's a beautiful thing to watch. I played these songs in some of the poorest parts of the Smoky Mountains of Tennessee. I played these songs at yacht clubs down the Cape. And it truly doesn't matter. That his ability to reach folks is really like anything I've ever seen. And this song is a song I think you'll all like. I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. Keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the time.
'cause you're mine. I walk the line.
The song before, I said I was going to do two more songs, which, I mean, this is the last song I'm going to do. And thank you very much for coming. If you're interested in CDs, books, the books are basically an extenuation of these stories I talk about. It talks a little bit about their careers, talks about just kind of the influence of the four members of the Highwaymen. People like the book. The thing that people like about the book, from what they tell me, is that when I do these concerts, people come up to me afterwards all the time and they say, I love me some classic country music. I love me some Merle Haggard. I don't like modern country music, and I'm not a fan of modern country music either. But there's all of this incredible modern music, country music that does exist, that's really steeped in the traditions of artists like Willie and Waylon and these guys. And I know because I get to be their opening act doing my own music a lot when they come through Boston and Providence and Worcester. And so I try to kind of connect people with some of those artists, and hopefully they seek out that music, and they do. Sometimes they email me and tell me they did. So if that's of interest to you, I do. I have a CD of me doing the songs of Willie, which I just recorded over the winter, and then I have an album of me doing the songs of the Highwaymen. I have mailing lists. I have business cards. I'm going to stop talking. I'm going to play one more song, and then everybody's going to begin their weekend. I guess this is the weekend.
Just one party, then another. I broke her heart so many times. Had to have my party wine. And that one day she said, sweetheart, well, this party is over. Burn out the light. The party's over. They say I'm the next man. Let's call it a night. The party's over. Oh, tomorrow starts that same old thing again. Oh, tomorrow starts that same old thing. Oh, tomorrow starts that same old thing again.
Thank you very much. Thank you to the Cultural Council, the library, and everybody for having me.
Have a good night.